In this video, I'll share my thoughts on the recent backlash towards MetaMask or Infura for stating that they collect users' IP and the wallet address. I'll also share the workarounds to protect yourself if you are concerned or if you'd like to continue using MetaMask, and contrary to the popular belief, why just switching to Alchemy or Anchor's RPC is not enough. Hello everyone, welcome to One Life Investments. This is me, your host Prodswell. Before getting into the video, I would like to preface that we don't give out any financial advice on this channel. This video is for education purposes, and if you find this useful, please leave a like, drop a comment, and share with people that might find it useful as well. I know I'm a bit late on this video, but I just wanted to let everything play out and actually come up with a video that actually makes sense or is actually really helpful for a long run. Now, on November 24, Consensus published a blog post in regards to its privacy policy update. The main highlight of the post was this, and quote, "When users interact with Ethereum or other blockchains, such as by sending a transaction or requesting a balance through an RPC provider such as Infura, the provider receives both the user's IP and wallet address to provide the service. This is not Infura specific and is consistent with how web architecture works generally," end quote. So basically, they are hinting that that's how the web infrastructure works and is similar to you visiting a website using a browser or something like that. Now, it does kind of makes sense. The issue here is that we want anonymity at least while using decentralized applications, and if our wallet info and the IP is stored somewhere or by any third party or whatever, it defeats the purpose of decentralization and privacy in general, right? So before getting deep into the video, there's a few things you should be aware of so that this video actually makes sense. The first is, what is a RPC connection, or what is a remote procedure call? Second is the relationship between Infura, Consensus and MetaMask. And you should also understand that Infura serves Ethereum users. So if you are concerned while using other chains, for example, Avalanche, Solana, Matic, or any other blockchains, you should look into them separately. While I was preparing this video, Infura has highlighted that they are actively working on decentralizing their infrastructure, and the data they are currently storing, which is the IP address and wallet address, they're looking to store it only for 7 days. Now, I'll probably cover that in another video, so make sure you are subscribed or following us on Twitter. Now, moving over the video, what is a RPC, or what is a remote procedure call? I'll try to make it as plain simple as possible. RPC stands for remote procedure calls. To put it simply, whenever you try to interact with the blockchain using any application, dApp, wallet, whatever, the RPC servers are the gateway to and from that blockchain. They handle the communication to the desired blockchain and back to the end user, which is you. For example, in the picture, you can see that the client is calling a function basically, and it's going to the server. This is where the RPC server is pointing towards, and that server will carry out the transactions or instruct the blockchain regarding any instructions you've given them. For example, a swap, a transfer, a purchase action, a selling action, whatever it is carried out on the blockchain, and whatever is the end result is received by the server, which is the RPC server, and that server will send the information or the result back to the client. So that is what a RPC server does. So that's what a remote procedure call is, right? If you'd like to learn more or learn more in depth, I'll leave the link to the resource in the description below, but I hope that this just made sense on what an RPC basically does, or what is a basic RPC operation. Second is the relationship between Infura, Consensus and MetaMask. As you can see, Consensus had a suite of products that you can choose from or that it provides to different other companies as well. One of them is Infura, another one is MetaMask, and they have a few others as well. Consensus is the parent company that owns MetaMask and Infura, including 6 other products. Infura is the default RPC provider for all the MetaMask wallets by default. Now, once you're aware of these things, it will help you to wrap your head around the situation and actually make better decisions depending on a personal requirement. I would like to remind you that there's no one solution that fits into each and every situation. So depending on what you are looking for and what you use, what dApps, what applications you use, the solution might vary. And depending on your tech skills as well, you might want to be looking into something that's very easy and the one that makes sense to you. So if you'd like to discuss anything else that I don't cover in this video, please make sure you leave in the comments or reach out to me on Twitter so that we can have a chat. Once Consensus made it public that they do track the IP address and the wallet address, everyone rushed to change their IPC address on the MetaMask wallet, and some even pivoted to other DeFi wallets out there. So what is the solution if there is one, right? So I did some digging and here's what I found. First thing is, I would like to shout out Chase Wright. I'll make sure that the user link or the link to this tweet is in the description below. So he goes through different parts of MetaMask installation and signing up and creating an account. There's two things that stood out for me from here. The first is, when you create a new account or wallet in MetaMask, it is communicated with Infura. Now, this kind of makes sense because creating an account basically means communicating with the blockchain and letting them know that you want to create a new account. So there's no way you can skip it, right? And since you cannot alter any settings inside MetaMask without creating or importing an account, your wallet address is reported to Infura by default when you just create an account. So that's something you got to make sure that you understand. Second is, it's a pain if you use dApps that are on different chains and you have to change networks frequently. Now, this brings us back to Infura. Infura serves Ethereum users. Now, this situation only applies to users on the Ethereum blockchain. So if you are using a different kind of blockchain, for example, so let me show you an example of using different chains on the same wallet. So for example, I'm using Uniswap, which is on Ethereum. So for example, I go and change my RPC server, which I will show you in just a second how you can do it. Let's say this is the RPC server, which is actually very private or whatever. So I'm using Uniswap, it works fine, that's all good. Now I go to QuickSwap, which is on Matic, right? So if I go and click on that, switch to Polygon, approve, switch network. Now I'm connected to the Matic blockchain. Now this is going through a different RPC server. So for example, if you are really concerned on Infura storing your wallet address and your IP address, chances are the RPC server that is being used by Polygon might also store the information. Now I haven't checked the one that I'm currently using, so I cannot guarantee that this is storing or it's not storing, but that's just an example of, if you use different chains, you got to make sure that the different RPC server that chain connects to is sensitive resistant or is not sharing or storing information, right? The problem lies when you want to change, so for example, you change your RPC server to Alchemy or any other RPC provider that you prefer, and you use a different chain. Now when you go back and you want to use the same RPC server or the different or a dApp that's on Ethereum, let's say I want to connect my wallet MetaMask to Polygon, I'll change the Ethereum, it'll ask me to switch the network, which I'll approve, switch network. So what happens is, if you go and check on MetaMask, you see it goes back to Ethereum mainnet. So every time you go back to Ethereum mainnet, you need to go back to the RPC server that you think or that you believe is privacy, that supports privacy and is not storing your data. Now, this is a small hurdle if you are confident with other RPC servers, but it is a pain that you have to go back and forth and you don't have a permanent solution when changing an RPC server. So now moving on to what other options one has if they are concerned about this. Like there's a lot of different options, but there's two main ones that I can suggest is, either choose a privacy focused RPC if you would still like to use MetaMask and you don't want to move away from MetaMask and you believe that they will definitely come up with a solution, but for the time being you want to use MetaMask, but you can use other RPC servers, right? And I will also use a VPN on top of that as well, and I personally use Dashlane that offers a password manager and a VPN service for a decent price, which works for me. If you'd like to learn more about that, leave a comment and I'll make sure that I prepare another video which covers that as well. But I can also suggest any VPN service at the moment. Depending on your situation and your requirements, it might differ, and also the location you're from. So just make sure that you're using a VPN as well on top of whatever precaution you're using, right, or applying. Second is, I would use a privacy focused DeFi wallet that does not store any of my wallet information for interacting with the blockchain. Currently I'm looking at a couple of wallets that have been vouched for very reputable users, so make sure you subscribe to the channel to watch that video once that's up. The problem with moving away from Infura is that it only solves the issue when interacting with the Ethereum blockchain, which I showed you earlier. So you'll have to manually find out if the chain that you use, for example, Matic Avalanche, has a privacy-focused RPC server in place. Now, the good news is, while I was preparing the video, Chainlist came up with a new feature on this site. So So if you go to chainlist.org, I'll make sure that every website or document I mention will be in description. Go to Chainlink on the site. It ranks different RPC servers on the level of privacy they offer their users. For example, go to chainlist.org, search for Ethereum. There's Ethereum ETC, there's Ethereum Fair, Ethereum Mainnet, this is the one we're after. If I click on the arrow, and as you can see, it shows you the privacy tab. Now this is, again, you're trusting chainlist.org, but you are trust, I do trust chainlist.org for the time being. And if you're not really sure, as if you hover over the green tick, it will show you the document that they've taken this information from, which you can go and check for yourself before actually fully trusting them, right? So there's RPC, the flashbots, there's pocket network as well. So if you'd like to learn about how to add your pocket network to your MetaMask, I have a tutorial on that already, so I'll just link that in the description, or it should be in the top right corner if you want to go and watch that. Now once you find a RPC server that you think is suitable for you and you would like to use that, for example, one RPC, what you do is you copy the URL, right? You open your MetaMask, you go to your networks, click on add network, open in a new page, add a network manually, network name, let's say privacy RPC ETH. URL is the URL from Chainlist, which you copied. So one RPC, this is the one I'm using. It's up to you, whichever you prefer. Copy URL, paste it here. Oh, I already have this one. I'm gonna use flashbots. Copy that, paste it. Let me just flashbots chain ID. Let's go one. Symbol is ETH. Block Explorer, predominantly etherscan.com. So this is just a scanner. Whenever you go and open your wallet, and then when you go Account Explorer, or whenever you go an activity and find a transaction, that is picked up by here. Go save. And as you can see, now I'm using Flashbots RPC ETH. So now this is, I'm using a privacy focused RPC connection. Now you still want to use MetaMask, you don't want to use any other wallets. One of the main wallets that I'm looking at is called Block Wallet. A lot of you might have already heard about it or might have been already using it. So that is one in the list. So if you want to use Block Wallet, I'm not 100% sure yet, but this is a wallet that's been vouched by a lot of users, right? But I want to test it for myself and see if it does stand up to the expectations, right? So for example, you use different chains. So for example, you use multiple chains on MetaMask. What I would suggest is go and find all the networks, for example, Avalanche, C-Chain, find one for that. So for example, 1RPC has, I think 1RPC has a RPC server for all the networks. So what you do is copy that and go to your wallet. Click on that, add a network. I like to do it manually because I want to give it a useful name that I can remember. RPC URL is this. Network name will be AVAX private. Chain ID is 43114. Paste it. Currency symbol is AVAX. Block Explorer is, I believe, Snowtrace. This is up to you, whichever Block Explorer you want to use, or you just want to use the one default. I think this is Snowtrace is default. Save that, and you can use AVAX private. So now this is one of the workarounds. The second, as I mentioned, is a wallet, and third is VPN. But then I would use a privacy focused RPC server and then VPN on top, making it much more secure, right? So I hope this was helpful. If you have any questions, or if you think I've missed out on a lot of things, make sure you leave in the comments below, and make sure you subscribe, as I'm trying to put out more content, and I've been gone for a while, but if you're still here, welcome, and there should be more useful content in the future as well. And if you have any suggestions or would like me to check out any useful crypto projects that have a good future in moving into 2023, I'll make sure I check them out as well. And until then, take care and you have a nice day. Thank you.